Hello everyone, I am Pawel, I work in Google and Operations Research Team, and today I'd like to talk about ORtools. This is a set of combinatorial optimization algorithms developed at Google and open sourced, along with high-level APIs to model various real-life problems. And already now I'd like to point your attention to this link here, developers.google.com/optimization. It is the home of ORtools, and it contains a lot of useful information how to use it in practice. So what is ORtools? First off, it's a set of high-level APIs that allow you to model many different problems. You can use linear programming or mixed integer programming. We also support satisfiability problems and constraint programming. And we have a solver for vehicle routing problems and a set of specialized problems from graphs like max flow, min cost flow, etc. So you can model all these different problems with very nice high-level APIs, and then under the hood you can solve those problems with a corresponding solver, so LP, MIP, SAT, CP, VRP, or some specialized graph algorithms. And all of this together is bundled inside ORtools. So ORtools is a very comprehensive framework that allows you to model and solve many different combinatorial optimization problems. So let's now just go for a quick tour and see how you can do it in practice, step by step. Start from linear programming and mixed integer programming. First off, what ORtools give you is a high-level LP MIP solver wrapper that allows you to use whatever LP or MIP solver you have at your disposal. We support GLOP, which is in-house Google implementation of primal and dual simplex, but we also support other open solvers like CLP and GLPK, as well as the commercial solvers if you have a license for it, Groby, Express, or NCplex. Similarly for MIPS, we support open solvers Skip, GLPK, and CBC, and the commercial ones Groby, Express, and CPlex. We also support Google-made pure integer programming solvers, POP and SAT, and a specialized Google-made solver just for knapsack instances. And all of that is written in C++. Actually, all of our tools is written in C++, but we have, through Swig, APIs in other languages, notably in Java, Python, and C#. So how would you model a MIP inside ORtools? So on the left hand side here you have a mathematical formulation of a MIP. There is an affine objective, so minimization or maximization of this term here, subject to a set of linear inequalities with some bounds on the variables, and then for a subset of variables or all variables you specify which of those have to be integer. So how would this be expressed programmatically in ORtools? So ORtools use what is known as protocol buffers or protos, and this is a Google technology that we rely a lot on. And you know, essentially it's basically a struct. This is like JSON but with extra strict type checking and support for multi-languages. So in here you have high-level model proto, model struct, that contains information on the objective direction and the offset, and then just a list of variables and constraints, where each variable and constraint is a proto of itself. So then you have a variable proto, which defines a single variable with its bounds, objective coefficients, and indication whether it's integer. And just so you know, the bounds can be infinite, so it doesn't have to be boxed. It could be one side bounded or even unbounded variable. And similarly for constraints, you have a proto that defines the bounds, which can again be infinite, and a list of variables by index and a list of corresponding coefficients that are involved in this constraint. So this, all of this together defines you a MIP. So just an example here, you know, max to x0 plus x1 such that x0 plus x1 equals 1, and all both of the variables are binary, this corresponds to this proto. You could just open your text editor manually, type this in, and then this would be a MIP which can be solved with ORtools. Of course, normally you don't do it by hand, but programmatically, and there is also an API to programmatically fill those in. I encourage you to look at the ORtools homepage to know how to do it. And we also have specialized APIs to do this. What I presented to you is the linear part, so the classic MIP and classic LP, but many MIP solvers actually support a bit more. They support a range of, I would say, specialized types of constraints, and you can also express those inside the linear solver proto. So these constraints are indicator, SOS of type 1 and 2, quadratic constraints, absolute value, and an OR across a list of variables, and min and max across a list of variables, as well as you can also define a quadratic objective. And if this is, if these features are supported by the underlying solvers, they would, it will be translated by the ORtools internal machinery and used appropriately. Let's now move to feasibility problems and constraint programming. This is a dedicated solver that has been developed at Google. So this is not a high-level wrapper, this is just a solver and a corresponding API to it. So the solver is called CPSAT, and this is a constraint programming solver that at the core uses a SAT solver. And I would like to start by emphasizing that this is likely the best constraint programming solver in the world currently. So there is an international challenge called Minizinc for constraint programming solvers, and CPSAT from Google has been winning this competition for the last 2 years. We got 4 golds a year ago and 2 years ago. And just so you know, there are five categories in this competition, but in one we are not allowed to run for whatever reasons. So, you know, we got 4 golds out of 4 that we could get. So this is to show you that this is really a powerful constraint programming solver, but also this is a relatively strong mixed integer programming solver. Note that you can take your MIP and by discretizing the continuous variables, maybe with some upscaling, you can turn your MIP into a pure integer program. And we actually ran MIPLIP instances from MIPLIP 2017 and tried to solve them with CPSAT. And there are a few cases, a few instances, which were open, meaning that no existing MIP solver could actually close those problems, but CPSAT closed them. And I just want to emphasize the speed. It closed them relatively quickly. Now, this is not to tell you that CPSAT is super efficient on all of the MIPS. No, it's just that there are MIPS on which the techniques involved in CPSAT solver are actually more efficient than the classical techniques used in a standard MIP solver. And this is emphasized especially by this case of NEOS 321 something something SOVI instance, which is closed by CPSAT in about 6 minutes. Or by ParaExpress, so you know, high performance computing, distributed express, 21 days. Okay. Again, this is a very extreme case, and normally for MIPS, a MIP solver would likely be more efficient than CPSAT, but this is to show you that it at least makes sense to try out CPSAT on a MIP as well. So let's go back to actual constraint programming. What kind of modeling features you have from a user perspective supported in CPSAT? So again, we have a proto. So this is an ORtools/SAT/CPModel.proto. And then you have these protocol buffers, these structures that allow you to express your model. And we support a range of different constraints. We have no overlap constraint, such that the interval is like a variable which represents a task in a scheduling-like problems, and you say that they cannot overlap. So this is quite useful for scheduling. You have also cumulative constraint. So this is similar, but the tasks, the intervals can overlap, but they also have a height. But when they overlap, they cannot go above certain height. We also have like a full no overlap in two dimensions. So 2D boxes that cannot overlap. Boolean constraints, so you know, OR and implications, equivalences, negations, linear constraints, so classical linear constraints, and linear constraints with enforcement. So this beast here stands for some Boolean expression, and if this Boolean expression turns out to be true when solving the problem, it will then enforce this linear constraint. So if this is true, this also has to be true. If, however, the Boolean expression evaluates to false, this linear constraint is not enforced. We also have element constraint. So this index here is a variable. So you can basically pick some other variable by a variable index. You also have circuit constraints, which allows you to, which is very useful in TSP-like problems, that allows you to enforce your variables to form a closed loop. A table constraint, such that, you know, for some tuple of variables, you just enumerate what tuples of values are admissible, and many, many more. All of that allows you to model various problems like scheduling, routing, etc. With these native constraints. And we have propagators, dedicated propagators for all of these constraints that make the solving quite efficient. Okay, let me now move to VRP, vehicle routing problems. ORtools allows you to model and solve many different types of VRP problems. And I will just give you one example, which is TSP. So, and this is gonna be in Python because it's quite short code. So to solve a TSP problem, you have to define your own distance metric between the nodes. So here is very dumb. Of course, this would need to be some real data here. And then to solve this, you first have to create the problem itself. You say how many nodes you have, how many vehicles are there, and how many depots you have. So for TSP, we have no depots, we have one vehicle, and in this particular example, we have 10 nodes. Then we instantiate the solver itself with the model that we just created. Then we register the distance function and use this registered function as the cost function when traversing the graph. And then we just hit solve, and it's going to solve the problem for you. And the API is rich. You can model many different VRP-like problems. And as far as I know, VRP is probably the most used around the world part of ORtools. It's really efficient and it's really tailored towards VRP problems, and it works really, really well. And let me just finish with specialized graph algorithms that we have in ORtools. And I will show you this on an example of min cost flow. How would you solve a min cost flow with ORtools? Again, very simple. You would instantiate the solver for min cost flow, and then you would just add all of the arcs that you have. So for every arc, you define the starting node, the end node, the capacity of the arc, and the cost of flowing through the arc. And then you add all nodes, and for every node, you add the supply. And you know, this allows you to define source and sink nodes. A source node would have a positive supply, a sink node would have a negative supply, and a transit node would have a zero supply. And that's it. You just hit solve and wait for the solution. And of course, here I just show you how to access the cost, but of course you can also access the actual flow values as well. Again, refer to the online guides and references on the ORtools homepage. So that's it for the high-level APIs. I showed you how to model LPs and MIPS, what sort of constraints we support for the constraint programming solver. I also showed you how to solve a simple VRP problem and how to solve a dedicated graph problem. And of course, for all of these domains, we have the underlying solvers. So I would like now to just give you a quick tour of all of the solvers that have been developed at Google, and they are included in ORtools automatically. So first we have the linear programming solver, we call it GLOP, and this is primal dual simplex. Then we have what we call an old constraint programming solver, and this is a solver that powers the VRP solver. And this is something we developed like 10 years ago, and the main technology used there is propagation. And on top of that, the VRP solver adds a set of heuristics dedicated just for VRP. So this is it. Some time ago, we noticed that one can build a more powerful CP solver using SAT technology. So we have the third family of solvers based on SAT. So we have a SAT solver, which just solves satisfiability problems. And the main algorithm there is conflict-driven close learning. And then we use the SAT solver as the main building block for the other integer programming solvers and CP SAT solver. So we have BP solver, so binary programming solver, called BOP. And this is basically a range of different heuristics plus SAT solver, and bundled all together, this is capable of solving binary programming instances. Then, of course, we have the flagship, which is CPSAT. So this is a constraint programming solver based on SAT. So it also has propagations, but it also has instantaneous translation to SAT to learn new clauses, and also it uses LP. So it's really a mix of many different techniques. The reason why VRP solver here uses the old CP solver is that in the old CP solver there is a range of heuristics dedicated for VRP which are not present in the CPSAT solver. And of course, CPSAT solver can be used as an integer, as a generic integer programming solver, and this is just CPSAT plus CATS that we have implemented, and we sometimes call it CPSATMIP. And last but not least, we have the graph algorithms. So we have linear assignment, max flow, min cost flow, matching algorithms, components, strong components, strongly connected components, clicks, and many others. So altogether, you see we have in-house Google-made solvers for linear programming, constraint programming with a specialized application to VRP, and SAT-based techniques to enable generic constraint programming solver, and a dedicated graph algorithms. So that's a very rich set of different algorithms, and I think this is likely the richest combinatorial optimization library you can find. So thank you very much for your attention. See you on the Zoom session. And once again, I encourage you to have a look into the ORtools homepage, developers.google.com/optimization. Thank you very much.